I am Pritam and in this video we are going to study about the connections or wiring of a fluorescent lamp. In this video we will study about the connection as well as how to improve the power factor of a fluorescent lamp. Okay, so to do that experiment, what we need? DPST stands for double pole single throw. Okay, so this one is my DPST switch, double pole single throw. That means when you switch on a single switch, just single throw, both pole, phase and neutral, are getting connected. So what is phase and neutral? So phase and neutral are the two terminals of a single phase alternating supply, alternating voltage. Okay, so 15 means single phase, 230 volt is the voltage and supply will be, and the supply is AC, right? So if instead of AC, if it is DC, then instead of writing phase and neutral, we should write plus and minus. Okay, so plus and minus corresponding to DC supply, and phase and neutral is corresponding to the AC supply. So when you are going for single phase AC, you just write one phase and one neutral. But when you are going for three phase supply, there may or may not be chance for existing of neutral, either three phase only, phase R, phase Y, phase B, and sometimes if it is four wire system, then phase R, Y, B with one neutral point are there. Okay, so after that we use one fuse. What is a fuse? It is a rotating device. Okay, so it is a wire, metallic wire, having some resistance. That means when you connected the fuse, for example, in some situation your current increases due to some short circuit fault or some fault, your current increases in the circuit. What happen when current is increases in the circuit? That current must flow through this fuse, na? Once it flow through the fuse, the heating of fuse increases. The temperature of the fuse, temperature of that fuse wire increases. Once the temperature increases, this fuse will melt and it actually isolate the phase from the rest of the circuit. Okay, that is why fuse is a rotating device, right? Then after we'll have the wattmeter here. See, simply when you are going to install a fluorescent tube in your home, you no need to use this wattmeter, ammeter, voltmeter, because these are the indicating devices. These are the meters. Okay, we just want to find what is the voltage, current and power inside the lab. That is why actually we are doing some experiment. So for that we need some idea, rating, we need some values. So what the consumption will be there? That is why you are using the meter, that is wattmeter, voltmeter and ammeter. But when you are going to install in some place the fluorescent tube, so no need to use any meters. Okay, and so this is the wattmeter, and I told you wattmeter is connected in series and parallel. So you have four terminal M and L. So M L is connected in series. You can see this is a straight line, that is why it is a series connection. And when the C and M are getting short circuited here, so this is a common terminal, and this is the potential. You can say this coil is current coil and this coil is potential coil or voltage coil. Obviously voltage is connected in parallel, so voltage coil should be connected to the ground, one to the line and one to the ground, or can say one terminal is connected to the phase and the remaining terminal is connected to the neutral. Okay, then after we need to find what is the voltage. So what is the voltage means? Voltage is actually measured using voltmeter, and as we are giving supply 230 volt, the voltmeter should withstand more than 230 volt. That is why you can take 0 to 250 volt range. Okay, so if you take 0 to 150, are you able to indicate this value? No, because supply voltage is more than the rating. That is why below 230 volt rating is not acceptable here, right? And here in the V stands for voltmeter, and below we have a symbol like this corresponding to the AC. That means this voltmeter is a can this voltmeter can read AC voltage. If it is just like V and a straight line below, then that means that voltmeter can measure DC voltage. Okay, so but the thing is, AC voltmeter can measure both AC and DC, but DC voltmeter can measure only DC. And here it is ammeter. Ammeter also AC, and symbol is A. And the rating of wattmeter is 300 volt, 0.5 ampere. It's a unit power factor. That means cos phi is equal to 1. 300 volt means maximum voltage rating will be 300. 0.5 means it can take maximum 0.5 ampere of current. If more than this this current increases, if this current becomes 1 ampere, so this coil will burn out. If this voltage increases more than 300 volt, then this coil will be burn out. Okay. And that means if you are using a ammeter of 0 to 500 milliampere range, that means if your current is increases beyond 500 milliampere, this ammeter will go to hell. And if your voltage is more than 250 volt, then this voltmeter will go to hell. Okay. Then after, we are using a choke. Okay, this is choke. This is a you can say it's a inductive coil and having a core, and then we have tube light or fluorescent tube. A fluorescent tube have four terminals, two in each side. So here two terminal and here two terminal. So we are authorized to take connection from these two terminals, so we cannot touch inside the thing. And inside this tube light or fluorescent tube, we have the fluorescent powder. And here I have a starter. Okay, starter is used to just start the tube light or fluorescent tube. And I just want to say, so the parts of actually when you want to install a fluorescent tube, you need basically three things. One is a coil or choke. Second one is the fluorescent tube. Third one is the starter. These three is important and must required thing. Obviously you need wires. So these straight lines are wires. And a switch, DPST or SPST means single pole, single throw, whatever. Okay, so how to get connected? See, if I remove all the things, let me remove all this thing. Okay, from here to here I remove. Okay, if I remove this thing, what I do? I just take phase and connect it to the choke. Okay, so I told if this is series connection, phase to choke, one input choke, and output of choke is the input of one side fluorescent tube, and the next side is connected to the starter, and the next terminal of the starter is connected to the other side, one terminal of the fluorescent tube, and the remaining terminal is again connected back to the supply. Okay, so this is actually the connection when you are going to install in your home or in your place. So supply voltage, a switch, choke, starter and fluorescent tube, all should be connected in series. Okay, this is the connection actually to running the fluorescent tube. But in our lab, we are actually measuring something. So once you measure, you should connect the meters, right? Okay. So this is the actual diagram. And what happened when you switch on this DPST, that means this is connected and these two terminals is getting connected, then current will flow into the wattmeter, then to the ammeter, then to the choke, then to the starter and the fluorescent tube. Once the fluorescent tube getting started, I do not want to say you the detailed theory how does this fluorescent tube works. I just told you how to start it. So when you switch on this and this fluorescent tube will glow. Once it glow, then starter cut off, and after getting glowing this fluorescent lamp, we need to take the reading of wattmeter. Okay, so wattmeter reading should be in watt, then ammeter reading in amperes, and voltmeter reading in volt. So these three readings we need to note down in our record. Okay, so then after, what we do, we just take a capacitor I mean, after taking this reading, you again switch off this. Okay, after taking this reading, you again switch off this thing, because after switching off, the supply is getting isolated from the circuit, so no need for electrical hazard. Then you just take a capacitor and connect in between these two lines. That means capacitor is connected in parallel. Once you connect this capacitor, okay, once you connect this capacitor, then what you do, you switch on the supply. Okay, once you switch on the supply, again the fluorescent tube will glow and you will get some readings. Remember, fluorescent tube is a load, so load is always taking same amount of power. Okay, so there should not be any power changes in this ammeter reading. And supply voltage is directly connected to the voltmeter, so there should not be any changes in voltage reading. What the change happen? Change will happen in the ammeter. So you take this reading of a voltmeter, ammeter and wattmeter, and you see that from the previous reading only the ammeter reading deviated. So using P is equal to VI cos phi, you find out the power factor, and you can see after using this capacitor, our power factor is improved. So let's see how does this experiment works. Ready? So this is the setup for fluorescent lamp. This is called fluorescent tube. The white coating inside is the fluorescent powder. And here we are going to study how to connect this fluorescent lamp, and then how to improve its power factor using capacitor. So we have connected all these things with the circuit diagram. So this is the power supply box, and we are taking the phase here and neutral here. So this is a two terminal. When you consider about the single phase supply, we have to think only phase and neutral. Okay, you should not say any polarity like plus minus. For AC current, phase neutral. For DC current, plus and minus. Then, so with respect to circuit, go to take your circuit diagram. And in the circuit diagram, the phase is directly connected to the voltmeter one terminal. So this is the voltmeter terminals. As I am taking single phase, that is 230 volt, so I have taken here the range above 230 volt, that is 250 volt range. Okay, if your range is below 250 volt, then your voltage will not be so, and you are not able to take the actual reading. So whenever, whatever the supply voltage, take the scale which is above the supply voltage. Then the same terminal, because voltmeter is connected in parallel, so direct to phase and neutral direct connected to the supply. Then one terminal from the voltage is given to the ammeter. I mean, one terminal from the voltmeter is given to the ammeter, and output of ammeter is connected to the wattmeter. So here input one line, output is another line, and this is connected. I mean ammeter is connected in series. Then output of ammeter is connected to the M terminal of wattmeter. You can see this is the M terminal. M for main. Main stands for the main line supply. Okay, and as we know that M and C should be common. I mean, this wire is creating a short in between M and C, right? Then from L terminal, that is called load terminal, we'll take out the one wire and given to the load. This is the load setup of in fluorescent tube. And in fluorescent tube, we actually already connected this choke and the stator with respect to the holder. So do not bother about this thing as of now. You take out these two terminal. One is connected to the L of wattmeter, and the remaining terminal, second terminal, is connected to the V. Here we have V. We have three V terminals, and I am taking here 300 V terminals. You can see it is 300 here, right? Why 300? Because my power supply is above 230 volt, so I choose 300 here, right? So again, this V terminal is connected to the another terminal of voltmeter, and then to the supply. So when we plug in these two into the supply board, right? So this is our DPST.
So this is our DPST switch. DPST stands for double pole single throw. That means in a single throw, both phase and neutral are connected. When you switch off this, both phase and neutral are actually isolated. And this is called single pole single throw. I mean, for double pole, we have to use two different switches, right? But in here, only one switch responsible for double pole with a single throw. When you switch on, getting indicator, now it is connected. And when you switch on this one, your fluorescent lamp is starting to glow. So now it is actually glowing. Come here. See the voltage. What is the voltage it was showing? It was showing above 240 volt, right? That means the voltage is more than 240 volt, and as I am taking 250 volt range, so 250 volt range, so the below line is my actual reading, so it is about 245 volt. So I have told about the connection, and here now I am using without capacitor, so I have switched off the capacitor and the reading will be this. So the voltmeter will be 245 volt and the current will be 0.37 ampere, and the power will be 13 into multiplying factor. Okay, so now what I do, I just switch on the capacitor. So when you switch on the capacitor, there should not be any change of there is no change of voltmeter, but only change the ammeter. So when you switch on the capacitor, ammeter value reduces. I'll show you once. Now I switch on the capacitor, ammeter value reduces and it becomes 0.27, around 27 ampere, and voltage is remain same, 245 volt. Wattage remains same, that is 13 watt into multiplying factor. I mean 13 into multiplying factor watt. Reading, see, only one scale is given here, so I am getting around 12, 13. So I take 13, but do not take it as watt, because we have to multiply with the multiplying factor. So the value of this reading will be the indicating value into the multiplying factor. Now I want to find what is the multiplying factor. So as we know that here B1 and B2 are connected, and we are giving supply to the 300 volt terminal. So from this nameplate reading, you can see B1, B2 stands for 1 ampere. And here you can see 1 ampere, the top line, then 300 volt, the multiplying factor will be, the multiplying factor of 1 ampere and 300 volt will become out to 4. So the reading of this wattmeter is the indicating value here, indicating value, that is 13, into multiplying factor is 4. So 13 into 4. Okay, so by taking this reading, we do the calculation and find the power factor using P is equal to VI cos phi. So after addition of capacitor and before addition capacitor, we'll see what the difference of power factor, whether it is improved or not. Let's see in calculation.
So the reading corresponding to without capacitor, we have the wattmeter reading, that is 13 into 4. This is in watt and 4 is multiplying factor. V is 245, that is voltage. I is current, that is in ampere, 0.37 ampere. And the power factor, how to calculate the power factor? So we know that P is equal to VI cos phi. Here P is power, V is voltage, I is current, and cos phi is found to be 0.58. So it is no unit. And with capacitor, I'm getting the power 13 into 4. 4 is a multiplying factor. V is the voltage, 245 volt. I is the current, 0.27. And using the same formula, I found out the power factor is, power factor will be 0.78. So you can see that without capacitor, the power factor will be this much. And when I use the capacitor, the power factor improve. When I use the capacitor without using the capacitor, the power factor is found to be 0.58, and by using the capacitor, we found the power factor will be 0.78, and we see that there is an improvement of power factor from without capacitor to with capacitor.